Hello, and welcome to today's edition of Bobcat Update. I'm Jared Maxson. Today, we will share how COVID has been affecting students' mental health and how an upcoming career fair will benefit students. While the average number of new daily infections is declining, more than 675,000 lives lost to COVID-19, surpassing the death toll from the 1918 flu pandemic in this country. U.S. health experts continue to say the key to turning the pandemic around is getting more shots in arms. The youngest Americans, including those who aren't eligible for vaccinations, are increasingly at risk. Patients under 17 years old account for more than a quarter of all COVID-19 cases reported last week. It's been no small task for students dealing with the impact of COVID-19. They are doing their best to cope and to take care of their mental health. Bobcat Update's Carl Foley has more on the story.
COVID-19 has affected students at Texas State. Many are feeling anxious, but they are continuing to work through it.
Like, I would get anxiety at grocery stores because people were not wearing their masks and stuff when I wasn't vaccinated. But now that I am, I'm a little bit more eased down because of that.
The university's counseling center has had more students seek its service this semester as they cope with anxiety stemming from having more face-to-face interactions.
Now that things have, resumed to being mostly in person, we have found that students are feeling more anxious about getting back into the classroom, getting back into, a social support system, making those connections again, and feeling a bit rusty.
There are many resources on campus for students to take advantage of to help them deal with mental health issues.
We put together numerous resources around self-help available on our website for students to explore and engage in. We've been doing webinar series and content, so we bring in kind of our expertise as mental health providers.
The Counseling Center is located on the fifth floor of the LBJ Student Center. For Bobcat Update, I'm Carl Foley.
As the White House tries to convince more Americans to get vaccinated against COVID-19, many are wondering how long it'll take for hospitals to start feeling some relief. Doctors and nurses are being pushed to the brink as they struggle to handle the latest surge in COVID-19 cases. Some overwhelmed hospitals are now rationing care due to limited ICU capacity. Texas State students are gearing up for their first round of midterms in the next few weeks. That means they need time to study, and they need to find the right location to prepare. Bobcat Update's Noah Pearson has more on the story.
The Student Learning Assistance Center, or SLAC for short, is for many students the go-to place for studying.
Into the lab, you don't need an appointment, just stop by, get your homework already, and then a tutor will work with you from there. We also have supplemental instruction, so that's a tutor that's actually embedded into your course.
Slack has been beneficial for many students at Texas State and has helped many of them boost their GPAs.
Almost failing a class at one point, then I ended up going to Slack, got my D up to a B, which helped out my GPA immensely. And I would highly recommend it to anybody that's questioning it.
The Slack office is located in room 411 of the Alkek Library. For Bobcat Update, I'm Noah Pearson.
Texas State students may be eligible for scholarships from the University Federal Credit Union. These scholarships will be tied to the university's athletic program. Up to $100,000 will be given away in scholarships, and they'll be doled out based on the performance of Bobcat sports teams. Students will benefit from touchdowns scored in football, aces in volleyball, three-pointers in basketball, and home runs in baseball and softball. The scholarships are for this academic year only. Texas State Career Services helps pave the way for students to launch their post-graduation careers. Kendall Clark has a report on a semi-annual event designed to connect students with job opportunities.
The Career Fair is a three-day event to experience industry-specific career opportunities. The most recent Career Fair was held in the LBJ Student Center ballroom.
So we do career fairs every semester. It's to help students find jobs, right? So you're coming to school, hopefully with the intent to find a job post-graduation. Our goal is to assist you through that process. Career fairs are a really great way for employers to meet where you are here at your campus. And so every semester we host them.
Many students attended the career fair where they saw information about potential career paths and even finding new passions.
I actually went to a career fair my freshman year. It was like COVID based, but I actually learned like a lot of stuff and I helped pick my major of public health that I'm doing now. They were super friendly and they were like, you should totally do it. I was like, they sold me.
The gathering provides a chance to network with professionals and seek their advice. career fairs give students a better idea of which profession suits them and an opportunity to meet with employers within that category. For Bobcat Update, I'm Kendall Clark.
Coming up, we'll tell you what's happening at the Texas border and the latest on the Texas State softball team. You're watching Bobcat Update.
Multiple studies have shown that marijuana can slow both driver reaction and response time, which can be really dangerous. He's here.
He's here.
Wait.
What?
I can't drive.
Why?
My.
Oh.
U.S. officials have been removing migrants from their encampment in the border town of Del Rio, Texas. Thousands of Haitian migrants are staying outside near a bridge in extreme heat. An estimated 12,000 migrants have taken shelter under the Del Rio International Bridge. And as even hundreds have been removed from that location to take to their native countries, thousands more have been said to be on the way. All of them are seeking asylum in the United States. The Biden administration takes a swipe at the criminal aspect of cryptocurrency. Officials have imposed sanctions against an exchange called SUIX, which they say is conducting business with hackers. The sanctions forbid SUIX from having access to the American markets. This marks the most direct action the White House has taken against ransomware groups that freeze computers and then demand payment through cryptocurrency, which is harder to trace. Treasury officials also issued new guidance companies on how to avoid running afoul of U.S. law when making ransomware payments to criminals. Over the summer, new ownership revived a long-lasting San Marcos cigar and tobacco humidor that many locals enjoy. Earlier this year, Hill Country Humidor, located on the square, was in a bind, and many saw its long history coming to an end. This summer, it was saved thanks to new ownership. The shop has a new look that has employees and customers very excited. Hill Country Humidor is now called the Cigar Vault. The shop has been redesigned to make it more of a lounge to attract new customers. The Texas State softball team has released its schedule for the upcoming 2021 fall season. The home opener will be on Saturday, October 2nd against Texas A&M International. The Bobcats will play 8 games this fall, 5 at home and 3 away. The away games will be in Austin against the Longhorns, in San Antonio against the UTSA Roadrunners, and in College Station against the Aggies. Last season, the Bobcats had a 25-4 record at home, so they're hoping to continue using home field advantage when it's on the schedule. Autumn has arrived, and that means weather is going to get cooler as the days grow shorter. For those who live in North and East Texas, there's an expectation that the leaves will change color in the coming weeks. Before you know it, time will arrive for many of us to head to the pumpkin patch and stock up for the season. Changes will come a little slower for us living in Central Texas, but the calendar says it's autumn. We'll get roughly 12 hours of sunshine and 12 hours darkness this week. And coming up, perhaps it'll be cooler. That's all for today's newscast. I'm Jared Maxson. Please join us next time as we cover what's going on at Texas State University. Stay safe.